Thank you so much for your appreciation and love for the last few draping videos that I have put out on my YouTube channel. A lot of you have reached out to me requesting sari drapes which can be worn with synthetic saris. So fabrics such as chiffon, georgette and poly cotton. So I thought why not show you a drape today with a synthetic sari.
The drape that we are going to learn today is a halter gown drape. This drape is a variation of the nivi drape that we very commonly see around us today.
The sari I'm going to be using today is a printed chiffon sari, which is the one I'm wearing right now. This sari actually belonged to my grandmother and she bought this almost about 40-45 years ago. So it's a very, very old sari and it used to be one of her favorites. She isn't anymore, so for me the sari is really precious because it reminds me of her touch, of her smell and of the love that she always shared with me and with all the other grandchildren. So it is with the same love and intensity that I'm going to be sharing with you a very, very special drape today.
Unlike the handloom sari, the synthetic sari is see-through. And so I will be wearing the drape over a petticoat. You can skip the petticoat for tights or maybe a short skirt. Synthetic saris are super lightweight and they fly around a lot. And so to prevent this, I use a synthetic sari with a fall. So as you can see, my chiffon sari already has a fall attached at the bottom. To start draping, hold the inner end of the sari at your right waist and you can decide the height of the sari that is comfortable for you. Now you can tuck the top of your sari into your waist. I highly recommend tucking in at least about 4 to 5 inches of fabric into your waist. Continue to tuck the sari around the waist and complete one round. Notice that I am straightening out the micro creases at my waist as I am draping the sari. Next, take the pallu around the waist from the back to the front, just like you would for the common nivi drape. Leave approximately 1.5 meters of the pallu over your left shoulder. Don't worry, there is a reason for this. For now, please leave a long pallu. Now watch very carefully. Bring the upper border of the sari, which is on our left shoulder, bring it to the right shoulder. Simply pick the fabric up and bring it to the right shoulder. You can use a clip or a pin, or if you're like me, use your head. Now, take the pallu around yourself once more. Confused? Let's see this step once again. Bring the upper border of the sari, which is on our left shoulder, to the right shoulder. Secure that fabric onto your right shoulder. Take the pallu around yourself. There is some bit of flexibility and finger acrobatics that will be required over here. So please be patient with that. Now, as you will see, I have fabrics in both of my hands. One is the upper border that we brought from the left to the right shoulder, and one is the top corner of the pallu. Now, take both the fabrics behind the neck and tie a knot. The drape isn't over yet, but before the next step, I want to take a moment and show you how gorgeous and beautiful the pallu of the sari is. We still have to pleat the rest of the sari at our waist. tuck the extra fabric to the left and the right of the pleats. Adjust the sari according to your liking. Chiffon saris are very light, so it actually falls on its own and needs very little guidance. Since this is an old sari, I'm adjusting it with very nimble fingers. As you can see, the sari drape has a very, very smart halter back. If you are going to a party, you can wear this drape with a halter neck blouse. If you are going to the beach, you can even wear it with a bikini top. I'm going out for drinks with my friends and will be using this gorgeous metal gold belt to give the drape a smart evening look. Isn't the drape stylish? So what are you waiting for? Bring out those chiffon saris and make a drape and drape a look. Interested in learning in detail and having a personal sari guidebook, then please do check out the Fluid Sari Zine. I have recently published this book in which I show 5 different ways to drape the sari, all without a petticoat. It's also a coloring book. If you like this channel and wish to support it, please do subscribe. You will also receive updates on more draping inspirations and sari styling ideas. Thank you for watching, and I wish you a great day. Bye.